What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Jamie D Show. Woo! Live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST, and live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook at the Jamie D Show. Welcome in. What's up? So everybody who's listening in their cars right now live on the radio dial, thank you for not turning. And for those who are just coming into the YouTube, what's up? It's a pleasure to have you all here, family. Welcome, welcome, welcome. All right, so don't forget, guys, I need to tell you all this before we start the show. I have so many things going this week. So tonight I have Turnt Trivia Night at the Gold Coast Casino inside of the TGI Fridays. So, 7:30 to 9:30 p.m. tonight. Again, Turnt Trivia Night inside of TGI Fridays, which is located inside of the Gold Coast Casino, 7:30 until 9:30 p.m. PST. One last time. I have Turnt Trivia Nights tonight at TGI Fridays inside of the Gold Coast Casino from 7:30 to 9:30 p.m. PST. And then this Friday, I have my live remote from the Drip Bar Las Vegas. That's 4579 West Flamingo Road. 4579 West Flamingo Road. I have my live remote from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST this Friday. When you come out to the Drip Bar Las Vegas, you will receive a free IV vitamin therapy drip and your first month paid for courtesy of me, Jamie D. So come to the Drip Bar Las Vegas. Then there's more. There really is more, and I want you guys to stick around because later Friday night, I have my Canna Globe event, which I'm super excited for. It is a virtual dispensary owner opportunity mixer featuring the Canna Globe CEO, Marty Hill. Again, this Friday night, the virtual dispensary owner opportunity mixer featuring Marty Hill, who is the Canna Globe CEO, will take place Friday, September 22nd. From 7 p.m. until 9 p.m. PST. That's 317 South 6th Street, Las Vegas, Nevada. 317 South 6th Street, Las Vegas, Nevada. From 7 p.m. until 9 p.m. PST. One last time. Turnt Trivia Night today, 7:30 to 9:30. TGI Fridays, Gold Coast Casino. Friday, Drip Bar. 4579 West Wingo Road, 10 to 11 a.m. PST. And then the Canna Globe event, 317 South 6th Street, Las Vegas, Nevada. From 7 p.m. until 9 p.m. PST. So come check out the kid. Make sure to support me and help me out with my events, y'all. This is how I am able to get out there in the streets and get the Jamie D Show out there, by going to these events, hosting them, and getting sponsored by you all in the community. So thank you all so much. Welcome in Gina Chandler from California. What up, friend? What up? All right, let's get into some daily news. Because for the show rundown, it's daily news. Then we're going to have a conversation on if lying to get a job is acceptable. And then we're going to have a conversation on pranks gone too far. So, there's so much going on in the news. And I wanted to talk to you guys about this because, as stated by Hollywood Unlocked, The Talk did not premiere like it planned to this past Monday, September 18th. CBS previously announced that the daytime talk show will air new episodes starting Monday, September 18th. But now the return is on hold amid the ongoing WGA strike, which is the Writers Guild of America. Woo! They plan to come back this past Monday. CBS said they were going to come back this Monday, and now they're not because of the strike. I have to repeat that because a lot of people thought that the writer strike and the actor strike was just going to affect them and not other industries. But people are buckling down, and they're saying, no, radio, TV, y'all got to join the strike too. Now, I don't have a daytime talk show. I don't have writers. I don't work with actors. Unless, obviously, they come on my show. But even a lot of actors aren't even doing interviews anymore because of the writer's strike and the actor strike. So I'm not sure how daytime TV is being affected by the writer's strike or how they are not helping with the writer's strike. But if the writers and the actors are saying that they are not helping, I mean, I'm sure they're not wrong. The Talk is pausing its season premiere, a network spokesperson revealed in a statement on Sunday, September 17th. We will continue to evaluate plans for a new launch date, which is what they said. Of course, this move comes after Drew Barrymore's announcement that her show would not be continuing either after receiving backlash from Hollywood writers who accused her of crossing their picket lines. In a new statement shared to Drew Barrymore's Instagram, Barrymore's message read, quote, "I have listened to everyone and I'm making the decision to pause the show's premiere until the strike is over. I have no words to express my deepest apologies to anyone I've hurt. And of course, to our incredible team who works on the show and has made it what it is today. We really tried to find our way forward and I truly hope for a resolution for the entire industry very soon," end quote. Barrymore shared to her Instagram. The View, which is also a WGA signatory, opened its new season earlier this month and as such has seen its studio getting picketed. Daytime talk shows like The Jennifer Hudson Show also pushed their premiere back. Now, that makes sense. They are part of the WGA, again, Writers Guild of America signatory. So I can see why daytime talk shows like The Drew Barrymore Show, The View, The Talk, and more should not have come out with their season premieres or their new episodes. You all are part of these organizations that are fighting for rights for better pay. They're fighting so that your likeness is not being used without you getting paid. And they're also fighting so that you get treated fairly when your yearly contracts or whenever your contracts come back into play are treated with fairness. So I don't know why you guys would go out of your way to then still have your shows aired and continue to do your shows when you guys are part of those organizations. That makes sense. Again, my radio show isn't a part of that organization. I'm not even a part of those organizations. Do I support them? I absolutely do. Have I had people on my show to talk about the writer's strike and the actor's strike? I surely have. Do I message my friends who are in California and make sure they're okay and check up on people? Because even though I may not have the money to send to people or the space to house people, I'm doing what I know I can in my space to show up for my friends and family in the media and entertainment industry. So I can't be like super upset at Drew Barrymore or The View, or because again, I didn't know any of this stuff until I did my research and until I read this news broadcast with you. So now that it kind of makes sense, okay, I get it. And hey, you know, I feel like they probably didn't do it to be malicious. I don't think that we need to be like, oh my God, cancel Drew Barrymore, cancel The Talk, cancel The View. They aren't about the people. I don't think it's that serious. But I can see how, now knowing that they're part of that same signatory, why people are like, hey, don't do that. Come on now. Be about people. All right, guys, we're going to take a quick break. This is the Jamie D Show. Don't go anywhere. When we come back, we got some more daily news. Stay tuned.
Calling all entrepreneurs. If you ever wanted to own a cannabis dispensary, now is your time. Come out this Friday, September 22nd from 7 p.m. until 9 p.m. and meet the CEO of Cannaglobe, Marty Hale, the world's largest dispensary ownership platform in over 25 different countries and legal in all 50 states. Become your own boss with zero overhead, no employees to pay, or building to lease. Get your turnkey online dispensary business now. This free event will be at 317 South 6th Street, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89101. Again, 317 South 6th Street, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89101. Contact Anthony Boyd, a.k.a. Mr. 365, at 702-445-1885. Again, 702-445-1885 to receive free samples at this Friday's event. See you there.
Hash House A Go-Go, where we've been serving farm food and crafted cocktails for over two decades. Visit us for the full Hash House experience at any of our five Las Vegas locations. Hash House A Go-Go is where old school meets new and gets twisted. We bring people together over good food and fun. Come in for breakfast, lunch, or dinner, and come hungry because our portions are huge. Visit us online to see our entire menu at hashhouseagogo.com. Hash House A Go-Go. It's a Midwest thing, and there's nothing else like it.
Is your dog suffering from a sensitive stomach? Hi, it's Kelly the Cookie Lady from Mooch's Munchies. Our dogs had super sensitive tummies, and I needed to find a low-fat treat that wouldn't give them gas or other issues. Most of the treats on the market were loaded with fillers, chemicals, and chicken fat. Many of them weren't even food. Well, I knew I could do better, so I developed Mooch's Munchies, and I'm happy to be able to share them with you. Stop by our store or our website, moochesmunchies.com, and find out why we say that Mooch's Munchies are totally pawsome.
I'm Nathan Atkins, and I know the Drip Bar LV is the place to be for natural health and wellness. We offer wellness-boosting IV vitamin therapies designed to enhance your immune system, promote healthy aging, increase your energy levels, and improve athletic performance and recovery. Book your session today by visiting our website at thedripbar.com. That's thedripbar.com. Or give us a call at 702-846-0851. That number again is 702-846-0851. Mention you're a listener of The Jamie D Show and receive 15% off.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to The Jamie D Show. Woo! Live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST. And live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook at The Jamie D Show. I appreciate you all for being on the YouTube commenting. If you guys ever want to call in at 702-221-7283, feel free to. Again, that's 702-221-7283. Make sure to call in, express yourself with me, The Jamie D Show, on the things I'm talking about. Don't just call in just to talk about nothing. Keep it on topic. Just how we just spoke about the, you know, daytime talk shows pushing their dates back. Gina Chandler said live on the YouTube that no need to cancel the shows. They corrected their behavior. I agree. I feel like probably a lot of people who are in spaces like Drew Barrymore or who are media personalities or TV talk show hosts probably don't know all of the intricacies behind what goes into keeping the show alive and who they're associated with and more. So sometimes we put all of the pressure on the talent themselves. It's like they're just a face. They're not the, that's like, it's like shooting the messenger. They're not the ones who know everything that's going on behind the scenes. I don't know. Again, one day I will have my very own live talk show, daytime talk show that will win an Emmy for sure. I'm going to put that into existence. But until then, even I'm still learning about what goes into putting on a daytime talk show on a national network. All right, let's get into some more daily news. As written by Hollywood Unlocked, Jen Wiener, the creator of Rolling Stone magazine, has been fired from the board of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame Foundation. This decision comes after Wiener made controversial remarks about black and female musicians, suggesting that they are not as articulate as white people. Shocker. Wiener specifically mentioned iconic artists like Stevie Wonder and Joni Mitchell, implying they lack the same level of verbal prowess that white artists apparently possess. These comments have sparked outrage and led to swift removal from the prestigious board. Wiener was quizzed about the lack of diversity in his new book, quote, The Masters, end quote. He speaks highly of the likes of John Lennon, Mick Jagger, Pete Townsend, Bruce Springsteen, and Bono, but says that black artists like Curtis Mayfield and Marvin Gaye, quote, just didn't articulate at that level, end quote. Bear with me, y'all. I'm still trying to get over this congestion. He continued, quote, the people had to meet a couple criteria, but it was just kind of my personal interest and love for them. Insofar as the women, just none of them were as articulate enough on this intellectual level. It's not that they're not creative geniuses, end quote. Wiener's dismissal from the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame Foundation board sends a clear message that his views aimed at female and black artists will not be tolerated in the music industry. The foundation, which aims to celebrate and honor the contributions of influential musicians, took a firm stance against Wiener's remarks. In a statement, they emphasized their commitment to inclusivity and equality, making it evident that any form of racism or sexism will not be condoned. Let me know what you guys think on the YouTube or by calling in at 702-221-7283. Do you believe that it's racist or sexist to just have your remarks and think that some artists, whether they be black or women, aren't as good as white people? Is that racist? Is that sexist? Or is that just an opinion? Let me know. Should we be censoring people who have these opinions? Again, let me know on the YouTube or call in. All right, as stated by Hollywood Unlocked, a California mother who claims that her daughter was, quote, socially transitioned, end quote, to act as a boy without her parental consent while at school has reached a $100,000 settlement with the California School District. Jessica Conan claims her daughter was questioning her gender identity and was reportedly told by the school district that she needed to find out who she, quote, truly was inside, end quote. That's when Conan went on to claim that her daughter was told to use the boys' restroom and was addressed by male pronouns. According to Fox News, Conan, who had not been notified by the school of her daughter's, quote, transition, end quote, sued the Spreckles Union School District after finding out that Alicia had been identifying as a male while at school. Conan says, since this incident, her daughter has re-identified herself as a girl. Conan spoke with Fox News and said that she will continue to fight for parental rights. Quote, they need to understand their place and they need to stay in their place. In school nowadays, they're awful. So I'm going to fight this fight and keep fighting this fight, end quote, Conan told Fox News. Quote, I am not going to allow this to keep happening to children, end quote. Conan continued, quote, I feel that the fight, it has to continue, end quote. I'm going to play this news audio so that you guys can hear what Conan had to say.
Stand their place, and they need to stay in their place. And schools nowadays, they're awful. So I'm going to fight this fight. I'm going to keep fighting this fight, even though we have won against, we have, you know, settled our claim. And we, and for me, it's victory. For Alicia, it's victory. But my fight's still there. I'm not going to allow this to keep happening to children. I'm not. I felt like, yes, we did get justice. I felt like my daughter right now is, you know, she's at her healing part and she's been healing, you know, by getting this stuff out. So I do definitely know that we received justice. I think the fight should still happen as far as removing that parental secrecy policy out of schools. I believe that more cases should come forward. I believe Alicia being the bravest child that I know, the bravest one coming out. She's the first one to come out and talk her story. I think it took a lot of guts for both of us to be able to open up publicly.
So my thing is, and I want to know what you think, Mark, as well. My thing is I personally believe that everybody has a space to figure out who they want to be. And they're going to do that. Kids are kids, yes, but they're a lot smarter than we like to act like they are. Do I believe, though, that these schools should be transitioning their students without the parents' consent? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Unless a student is in immediate danger and they're being abused and they're being harmed, or they are in a space where they don't have a safe space at their home, schools should not be keeping parents out of their students' behavior, out of their students' quote-unquote transitioning, out of their students' mindsets, because while school systems are the parents away from the parents are still the parents, and they should still have a say-so and still have the say-so in their students and their kids' lives. What do you think, Mark?
I agree with you. And what happened to the parent meetings? What happened to parent-teacher meeting conferences and letters going home saying, hey, we need to discuss and talk about some things that we've seen with your kid?
Yep.
And I'm sure this lady probably had some idea. Maybe her daughter was dressing, maybe had a short haircut, you know, a lot of different things. And as parents, sometimes we kind of let, and me as a parent, and all parents are different, but I want to let my kids figure it out when they are younger. I'm not going to tell them how to dress. I'm not going to tell them.
So you're going to let them figure it out when they're younger?
When they're in their high school, 13, 14, 15 years old, like this little girl was. But I mean, I'm talking about not their identity as far as what the gender or what they want to be. But I mean, I let them dress. If they want to wear a blue shirt with a red pair of pants, I let them wear it. I'm not going to yell and cuss them out. I mean, my kids, once they got to high school, they went to private school, so it was all uniforms. But kids now can't make decisions. So what happened to schools giving the parents a courtesy and calling them and saying, hey, come in, let's sit down, let's have this conference.
Yep.
These are some of the things that we need to talk about that we have come to light and want you to, the parents probably knew, but want you to know, and this is kind of what our stance is.
Mm-hmm.
And then that parent can decide, okay, we're going to transition to another school, or we're going to transition to homeschooling or something like that. But then for them to just make that decision, the school was wrong, $100,000. She won that judgment. And I think that's, you know, at some point, money is sometimes a little bit of a small healer. I mean, you know, so I just think that has been lost with school, and this is just a reflection on what's going on in our globe.
Right.
Right. They don't want transgenders. They don't want that community to be in schools. Right.
So, Mark, let me tell you this. Let me ask you a question. When you were in high school or middle school, did you guys have counselors? Because we did.
Yes.
Like people we could talk to confidentially. Yes. You know, the sometimes they pull us out of class to talk.
Based on your your last name.
I don't even know if they have that now in
they
schools.
Do. They do.
Not in a lot of schools. They actually have been taken out. Like, for example, at my school that I was a teacher for, they didn't have counselors. I mean, I'm sorry. They did have counselors. They didn't have guidance counselors.
Guidance counselors.
Those are two different things.
Yeah.
But let me know if you agree with this or not. Because my thing is, do I think this is foul that the teachers kept away from the parents? Yes. Do I believe that students are transitioning? They always have. I mean, students being gay, students wanting to be tomboy or tomgirls or feminine or whatever, that's always
been happening.
They're
trying to find their identity,
But my thing is that we need to start creating a space where people feel comfortable enough to have these conversations with the parents and with the teachers.
Yeah.
I don't think that anybody should be held away from a student's growth because it takes a community to build a student.
Yeah.
Now, tell me if you agree with this or not. The only way I would say that this is okay is if the student went to that teacher or that counselor and said, I'm in danger. I don't feel like I could talk to anybody else. This is what I wanted to explore. Please don't tell my parents. Yes. I want to figure this out beforehand.
Right. No, I mean, I agree with that too, but I don't know. It's just as a parent, again, I can speak on this just as from a parent standpoint. I have a great communication with my kids, right? And there's not a whole lot, whether it's good, whether it's bad, whether they think I'm going to be upset, they will come to me and still say, hey, look, Dad, I got this situation. And what do you think I should do? And I've always gave them, even when they were younger, I've always gave them that door to say, no matter what you're going through, no matter what you see, no matter who's bugging you or bothering you, I've been there. I know that. And my dad had that communication, like, son, come talk to me. Let's not have any secrets, or you don't need to be afraid to tell me you want to be a different gender, or if you want to wear girl clothes, that's okay, because I always say kids go through phases, right? Their first phase, middle school, their second phase, high school. And then as they get older, they see things that are a little bit clearer and a little bit different. So how many kids can make a big, tough decision at 12 or 13 or 14?
And just like you said, before we go to break, everybody has a space where they're transitioning. When I say transitioning, I don't mean going from boy to girl. I mean, it's a growth period where they're like, hey.
Friends.
Right. Look, like literally sexually. Like men are wanting to touch women now.
Yes.
Women want to touch men. They're kissing.
100%.
They're going on dates. They're texting behind parents' back. Kids are in a growth period as much as adults are. You know, we're always learning. We're always figuring things out. However, I just believe that we need to stop acting like kids are in a space where they can't make decisions, because they definitely can.
Yeah.
They know what they want. They're doing what they want, because if we think about how we were as kids, we're doing the same thing.
It's the exact same thing. Minus a few gadgets, maybe minus the social media aspect. But our kids are, and I hear this sometimes from other kids, not my kids per se, but I hear it from parents that have kids, and it's like, you don't know what's going on right now. You're older. You don't. I'm like, nah, that's not true. That's just a way for a kid to excuse what they're doing, because a kid and everything they're doing now. And I tell my kids, I mean, they're adults now, but I've told this when they were kids. I said, everything you want to do, everything you even thinking about doing, I have done it.
Yeah.
Everything. Yeah. And so that hasn't changed.
You're not wrong.
So.
Yeah. Even Alicia says not everyone's parent is open to it, and that's why schools don't address with the parents. I get it. But like I said, unless that kid is in danger and they're literally saying, please protect me, then parents should know.
Yeah.
And parents and teachers should start working on a way to be able to address this with students without them feeling harmed or lied to. But okay,
before we just jump out of here, it sounds like they had, you know, her and her kid have a pretty good relationship, you know. It doesn't sound like she's like this parent who's in denial, but you know, you just never know the full story.
You never do, and I mean, probably a loophole.
Yeah, you don't know the full story. Lie, they probably reached out to her. She never got back to her. The child probably had a note in her bag, right?
Yeah.
So you know, it's just two sides. But you let your kids make decisions. Even like today, my kids are adults now, and it's like, a lot of things I taught them growing up, they've just transitioned into their adult life. And they're like, even today, they'll call me and, Dad, look, I got this a little situation. What would you do? Right. I give them what I'll do, and this is the pros and cons, and they'd be like, all
right,
thanks.
Right. Well, that's good. I mean, not everybody has that space.
Yeah, so no, and they don't, and some kids don't have that, but, you know, that relationship between kids and parents got to be tight.
Yeah, you're not wrong. All right, hey, we're going to take a quick break. This is Jamie D's show. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere.
ZenWorld Premium CBD offers full and broad-spectrum CBD oil, extracts, and capsules, which are designed to help you feel your best. Their products are sourced from the best organic hemp and natural ingredients on the market and are tested for quality, purity, and potency. They have a full range of items from health and wellness to beauty to pets. Call 725-205-9223. Visit online at ZenWorld.com or stop by their location at 9895 South Maryland Parkway and Silverado Ranch Parkway. Mention KSHP for 10% off in-store or use code KSHP online for 15% off.
Hungry for the best barbecue in Las Vegas? Come out to the infamous barbecue and meat market, John Moles Meats and Roadkill Grill in Las Vegas. John Moles was featured on the Food Network's Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. Now take home delicious meat selections for your grill, and while you're there, grab a bite of the best barbecue in Las Vegas. With two locations now at Tom and Gowan or on North Decatur, you're sure to find the perfect meats for your next barbecue or party. Find us online at johnmolemeats.com.
At AR Heating and Air Conditioning, our main goal is to provide high-quality service without breaking the bank. From maintaining your HVAC units to fixing them when they are down, they are there for you. AR Heating and Air Conditioning offer reasonable prices, reliability, and professional service at a great value. For more information, go to fixmyac.net or call 702-646-4000. Beat the heat and call AR Heating and Air Conditioning today.
Calling all entrepreneurs. If you ever wanted to own a cannabis dispensary, now is your time. Come out this Friday, September 22nd from 7 p.m. until 9 p.m. and meet the CEO of Cannaglobe, Marty Hale, the world's largest dispensary ownership platform in over 25 different countries and legal in all 50 states. Become your own boss with zero overhead, no employees to pay, or building to lease. Get your turnkey online dispensary business now. This free event will be at 317 South 6th Street, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89101. Again, 317 South 6th Street, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89101. Contact Anthony Boyd, a.k.a. Mr. 365, at 702-445-1885. Again, 702-445-1885 to receive free samples at this Friday's event. See you there.
And I know the Drip Bar LV is the place to be for natural health and wellness. We offer wellness-boosting IV vitamin therapies designed to enhance your immune system, promote healthy aging, increase your energy levels, and improve athletic performance and recovery. Book your session today by visiting our website at thedripbar.com. That's thedripbar.com. Or give us a call at 702-846-0851. That number again is 702-846-0851. Mention you're a listener of The Jamie D Show and receive 15% off.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to The Jamie D Show. Woo! Live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST and live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook at The Jamie D Show. I appreciate y'all for rocking with me live on air right now. Y'all, I'm so congested. I went to the doctor to make sure I wasn't sick. They said I don't got nothing, which is great. But the way allergies, my congestion, and all that stuff is kicking my butt. It is hard to talk, but I'm doing this. I'm doing it because I'm happy to be here. I'm grateful to be here, and nothing's going to stop me from shining in my light. When you got God behind you, let me get an amen, nothing is impossible. Hey, shout out to Fancy Fallon. Shout out to Gina Chandler. Shout out to Alicia Starr. Shout out to Naturally Radiant. I have people from Chicago, California, Las Vegas, Dallas in the house. Love to see it. Just want to let you guys know again, tonight I will be at TGI Fridays inside of the Gold Coast Casino. TGI Fridays inside of the Gold Coast Casino for my turn trivia nights from 7:30 to 9:30 p.m. PST. Tonight. That's tonight. Friday, I have the Drip Bar Las Vegas. That's 4579 West Flamingo Road from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST, giving out free IV vitamin drip therapies and paying for your first month of your membership. All courtesy of me, Jamie D. Y'all better get it while y'all can because I don't got money like that. Listen, I'm out here asking y'all to promote and sponsor with the Jamie D Show. So make sure y'all get those benefits before I can't give them to you no more. And then this Friday night, from 7 o'clock until 9 o'clock PST, I have the Canna Globe event with Marty Hill. The Canna Globe event with Marty Hill, who is a CEO, who's going to teach you all how to have and own your own virtual dispensary. Yes, you can own your own virtual dispensary and not have to do much work. It's a turnkey business. Not a Ponzi scheme, not a pyramid scheme, nothing weird like that, because the Jamie D Show will not be promoting it like that. If he did, he would let y'all know, because you know I'm always about holding myself accountable. But I did my research. I talked to the people. They've been in the studio. Make sure y'all come in this Friday. And if you want to do the virtual video, so that if you can't come into Vegas, let me know, and I'll send you guys the link so you guys can learn. You know, there's so many ways you can earn money in your sleep and have disposable income at your reach. All right? So make sure. Check it out. This Friday, September 22nd. 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. PST, 317 South 6th Street, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89101, the Virtual Dispensary Owner Opportunity Mixer featuring Marty Hale. All right. If you're just now tuning in, I already went over the daily news. Shout out to Naturally Radiant. Good to have you here. Amen, Gina Chandler. Amen. Won't he do it fancy? Yes. All right, let's get into this social topic, because I don't want to talk to you all about this for a while, but this is the way the show has been going, the guests we've been having on, just the conversations we've been having, it's been so good. So sometimes I haven't been able to do what I fully want to do in my show rundown, but we're going to get to this one today. The topic of today is lying to get a job. Ooh. Yep, you heard me. Lying to get a job. 702-221-7283. 702-221-7283. Or be like Naturally Radiant, Gina, Alicia, and Fallon on the YouTube right now. Comment what you think. So, y'all, I will not deny or confirm if I ever lied to get a job. Stares right at Mark Hayes in his face because he's the one who hired me. Because y'all ain't about to send me to jail or have my general station manager, Mark Hayes, looking at me sideways. Again, stares at him blankly. Okay. I'll tell y'all the truth. I know my motto is holding myself accountable and telling the truth. So, all right, I got you. I'm not talking about this job, Mark. Y'all heard that, right? So I definitely have he's laughing because I'm sure he has too. I've definitely exaggerated a bit to get a job. I wouldn't say I full out lied though. I mean, everything I exaggerated to get a job can always somewhat be verified. Anything that I've ever had to say to get a job could somewhat be verified. Would you call that lying? Yeah, I call it exaggeration. Now, to make this very clear, since my general station manager, Mark, is sitting right in front of me, he on the phone getting y'all calling in. Thank y'all for calling in. But I'm going to make this very clear, and I want Mark Hayes to hear this. I definitely did not lie or exaggerate to get this live morning radio position. I did not. Nothing about my resume, nothing about my actor's resume, nothing about my references were a lie. Everything was always the truth. It was all the truth. Mark said he got a fact check. I promise you, my resume was true, my headshot was true, my actor's resume were true, my references were true, all my social media posts are true. Everything to get media jobs has always been the truth. I can solemnly swear and testify. Now, when it comes to regular jobs, that I cannot confirm or deny. When it comes to regular jobs, you may see one of my best friends added to my work references. I mean, I know I can't be the Mark, have you done that before? Come on now. You haven't done that before? Never. All right. I guess I'm the only one who's speaking my truth. Again, entertainment jobs, media jobs, never done that. But, you know, a slight regular job, I may have put one of my friends out there. Williams family said, not Jamie covering us, but I promise you, I never lied to anything about Mark Hayes. Fallon said, I've lied not to lose a job. Ooh. Gina Chandler says he's talking about another job, Mark. But no, for real, my regular jobs, okay, let me see. For example, okay, when I was like a server in Atlanta, I may have put an extra bullet point or two to get the server position. Or like when I was applying to be a bartender, I may put an extra bullet point or two or put one of my best friends as my work references on my resume. But again, it was a little exaggeratory. I wouldn't say a full lie. Okay, so y'all maybe ask me why am I even talking about this. So as usual, I saw on social media, there's this one guy being recorded for lying to get a job. And y'all had me cackling. Now in this video, he is obviously lying to get a job he will never be able to do. But why not, right? I mean, hey, I never lied to get a job that I knew I couldn't do, because anything that I ever had to exaggerate a little bit, I already knew they were going to just teach us. Seriously, most of these jobs and their qualifications are ridiculous, knowing darn well they're going to train you the first day you start the job anyway. I mean, tell me if y'all agree. We have somebody on the line right now? We got Edward on line one. Let's bring Edward in. Edward, let's talk about this. Have you ever lied to get a job? Let me hear.
What's going on, Jamie? What's up?
What's up? From San Antonio, Texas, it's Edward.
There you go. That's what's up. God, you sound good. You sound fresh as a daisy, Jamie.
Hey, I appreciate it.
Hey, but to answer your question, yeah, man, I've lied, dude. I got a funny one. I was looking to be a bartender, and no one would hire me because I was a guy. So I started going to a club. Yeah, nobody would hire me. I started going to clubs. And I started faking an Australian accent and telling people I was from Australia. I swear to God, it worked, man.
What?
And I was telling people, yeah, it worked, dude. I told people I was from Australia and I was trying to get a bartending job. One place actually hired me, and then I told them I had to make up a lie to a lie and say I was going to speech therapy to learn better English. And it was, it didn't work. I don't know why, dude. I was so full of. I was so full of BS, dude. Like, I'm like, how is nobody calling me out on this, man?
Okay,
like,
hold on. Pause. Edward, we have to hear you do that Australian accent. Come on, give it to us. Give it to us.
Hey. Good day, mate. How you doing, everybody? Everybody doing all right? Can I help you out with some drinks?
Edward, I don't know if you're looking at my face on YouTube. I am bamboozled.
It was terrible.
What?
I don't know why, man. But I lied. I mean, I needed a job really bad, dude. I was hurting. And I just came up with some random, like, Keith Ledger BS, dude, and it worked, man.
Okay, first of all, I'm going to go ahead and ring the bell, because Edward, that was good.
That was
I was not expecting that. Okay, so again, I personally have never lied. I may have exaggerated, but dang, Edward, you take the cake.
No.
I respect, look, but hear me out, though. I respect it, because sometimes you got to do what you got to do to put food on the table and pay these bills. It's hard out here, Edward.
And the question is, like, how far are you willing to push the lie? Like, are you willing to do a fake Australian accent, or are you willing to put a few extra dots, a few extra I's, and cross your T's a little bit more?
Right. Look, Edward, I don't blame you. You know, I really appreciate you for calling in and telling the truth. Look, you got a safe space for me, Edward. Thank you.
Thanks, Jared.
Hey, you have a good rest of your day. So look, again, I'm going to just tell y'all, I can't speak for nobody else or Edward. I've never lied to that extent. Everything that I've ever done can always be verified. But if I ever had to exaggerate a little bit to get my regular jobs, listen, you're going to do what you got to do. These qualifications are horrible. So Edward, that was, better than the dang video I'm about to play. But let's go ahead and still play the audio of this guy lying to get his job. Take a listen.
I can definitely do it. No problem.
And do you want to go ahead and tell you about the program that we're hiring for as well?
Okay.
And the program we're hiring for is HomeServe.
Yes, ma'am.
It would be for inbound calls. Mm-hmm. You would be responsible for providing a high-quality resolution service for customers that are experiencing home repair emergencies.
Perfect.
Such as with their plumbing, electrical, gas lines, and heating and cooling appliances.
Mm-hmm.
As a repair management agent, you will learn a new strong critical thinking skills combined with strong customer service skills.
Yes, ma'am. Can I ask you one more question?
What?
Can I ask you a question? Is it just Korean, or would I be speaking English also? Would it just mostly be Korean?
I believe it would be mostly Korean.
Okay, that's even great. Even greater.
I'm over here choking because Mark's face has me dying. Okay, see, these examples are extreme. Now, if you have not seen this video with your own eyes, the two men who are in this video are black men. Knowing dang well They don't know Korean. And apparently don't even know good English, because this man said, that's even greater. That should have been that hiring manager's red flag right there. When he was like, that's even greater. I love my people. But I'm telling you, I should put this out there again. I did not lie to get this live morning radio personality position with Mark Hayes. I didn't. But if you go back and look at a little bit of the things I did to get regular jobs, hey, like I said, I may have exaggerated a little bit. Don't shoot me. I'm regular just like y'all. I am. And apparently everybody in the comments said they've done something to get a job too. Hey, it is what it is. Okay, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to have a conversation on pranks gone too far. So don't go anywhere. This is the Jamie D Show live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM. Stay tuned.
Calling all entrepreneurs. If you ever wanted to own a cannabis dispensary, now is your time. Come out this Friday, September 22nd from 7 p.m. until 9 p.m. and meet the CEO of Cannaglobe, Marty Hale, the world's largest dispensary ownership platform in over 25 different countries and legal in all 50 states. Become your own boss with zero overhead, no employees to pay, or building to lease. Get your turnkey online dispensary business now. This free event will be at 317 South 6th Street, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89101. Again, 317 South 6th Street, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89101. Contact Anthony Boyd, a.k.a. Mr. 365, at 702-445-1885. Again, 702-445-1885 to receive free samples at this Friday's event. See you there.
There's plenty of things to do in L.A., but nothing can compare to a day at Raging Waters Los Angeles. With 60 beautifully landscaped acres of slides and attractions, family fun for everyone. Catch a gnarly wave in the Wave Go, or race for the win on the super fast Raging Racer. With more water rides than any other water park in Southern California, Raging Waters Los Angeles is recognized as the state's largest water park. For more information, visit RagingWaters.com. Join us for a once-in-a-lifetime experience to see the Hoover Dam up close and personal on a guided tour of Lake Mead. Sit back and enjoy the cool breezes aboard the Desert Princess paddlewheel boat while taking in the sights of the greatest man-made engineering wonder of the modern world and National Historic Landmark. To reserve a spot on the Hoover Dam sightseeing tour or the Sunset Dinner Cruise, visit lakemeadcruises.com.
I'm Nathan Atkins, and I know the Drip Bar LV is the place to be for natural health and wellness. We offer wellness-boosting IV vitamin therapies designed to enhance your immune system, promote healthy aging, increase your energy levels, and improve athletic performance and recovery. Book your session today by visiting our website at thedripbar.com. That's thedripbar.com. Or give us a call at 702-846-0851. That number again is 702-846-0851. Mention you're a listener of The Jamie D Show and receive 15% off.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to The Jamie D Show, woo! Live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST. If you're just now tuning in, I went over the daily news. We had a conversation on if lying to get a job is acceptable. Mark said he's never done it. I said I've never really lied. I've only exaggerated. And I've never exaggerated for a job that I knew I could not do. It's always a job that I knew I couldn't do. Edward called in and said that he faked an Australian accent. It was actually pretty good. In the video, this dude lied and said he could speak Korean, knowing dang well he's never going to learn Korean. Stuff like that is way too far. That's not even exaggerating. It's not even lying. Like, you're just doing the most. But now, We'll have a conversation on pranks gone too far. Okay, so I know we have heard and seen many social media challenges, trends, and pranks that have gone too far and have unfortunately cost people their lives, i.e. the scarf around the neck challenge, the hold your breath until you pass out challenge, the one chip challenge, and more. Well, there are other challenges out there that aren't dealing with people actually risking their lives, but actually speaking death over other people. Yes, you heard me right, speaking death over other people. Now, if you're like me, whether you believe in God, Allah, a higher power, or whatever, what I truly know to be true is the power of our tongue. What we put in the universe is what we get right out of it. We have to truly be mindful of the things we speak over ourselves and others. Again, no matter what you may believe, one thing I know to be true is that we really do have the power to manifest things into our lives. I want to know what you guys think on the YouTube or by calling it at 702-221-7283. That is why when I saw this challenge come out a while ago, I completely did not partake in it, comment about it, or like any of the videos that were made because I absolutely did not want to put any energy into those types of videos. Even if the people's reactions in the videos were funny, because some of them were, or outrageous. Now you may be asking, Jamie D, tell us already. Dang, what are you talking about? Okay, I'm talking about the challenge where kids were going around and pranking their parents by telling them their favorite celebrity had passed away, i.e. such and such found dead at 39. Now, even though this trend is now over and it's a bit old at this point, it actually has resurfaced this past week and is back on social media as a way of going down memory lane, but now it's actually starting to gain popularity again and exposure. Now, even though I just said I didn't want to give these videos too much energy, it wouldn't be right if I didn't play the audio for you guys, because then you wouldn't get the severity of the trend. And some of you probably don't even know what I'm talking about. So don't drag me. For education purposes only, let's play this audio and discuss if there's such a thing as pranks or trends that is just across the board not okay and going too far. Take a listen.
Holy shit.
What?
Simon Cowell dead at 63rd.
No.
No.
You're kidding.
Dolly Parton dies at 76.
What? What? Are you freaking? Are you serious?
Oh my god.
No, it was 40 degrees.
What? John Bon Jovi dead at 60.
Shut up!
Oh my god, Andy Cohen dead at 54.
What?
Oh my god, Elton John dead at 75.
Fuck. Are you kidding me, Katie?
I'm kidding.
What? Taylor Swift dead at age 33.
No, you're kidding me. You're kidding me. You're kidding me. You're kidding me.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my gosh. Mom, Harry Styles dead at 28.
Shut up.
No, I'm not.
No.
Mom. Mom.
What?
John Mayer dead at 45.
No.
Yeah.
Oh my god, Mama. Jennifer Lopez dead at 53.
No.
Oh my god. What? Drew Barrymore dead at 47.
No.
I'm kidding.
Sweetie, don't do that.
Y'all. Kris Jenner dead at 67.
No!
What?
Zac Efron dead at 35.
No.
Stop. What the fuck?
Okay, I can't help but laugh at that last one. I'll tell you why. And again, I told you, some of the reactions are funny. I'm human, y'all. I'm human. I can say what I say and mean what I mean, but I'm going to also be honest. Okay. And I want to get Mark's opinion on this, because personally, I think that the trend is wrong, it's going too far, and you shouldn't speak death over people. When I was doing my master's program at the University of Maryland College Park, one thing that we learned about news personalities and news anchors and people in the news outlets in general is that they create obituaries early for people who they think they may be dying soon. And, oh my gosh, who did we do an obituary for? What was her name? Oh my gosh, I'm drawing such a blank. Who was the white woman who was in Congress? Oh my gosh, she was like a huge feminist. I'm forgetting her name. Jeez Louise, she passed away. What's her name? Oh my gosh, you guys are going to, Ruth Bader.
Ruth Gettenberg?
No, Ruth, why am I forgetting her name? Ruth Gettenberg.
No,
you're not even saying it right either. Your mic's not on. RBG. Ruth Bader Ginsburg. There we go. You said it so wrong. Your mic's not on. But sorry, y'all. Please don't drag me. Please don't drag me. But anyway, Ruth Bader Ginsburg. We had to write an obituary against her. And y'all know me. I speak up. I raised my hand and I talked to the professor and I was like, I don't feel right doing this. And she was like, it's a part of the program. It's what they do in the news. You got to get used to this. And I'm like, I don't want to write a story or an obituary about somebody who, quote unquote, may pass away soon. Because if they actually do pass away, I feel like I made that happen. And y'all know she died. I'm not laughing at her or her death. Please don't take that way. But she died literally like a month after we wrote that obituary. I was so upset. I felt so gross inside. But on the other hand, when I see the way people react to the passing of their favorite celebrities, I'm sitting here just like, y'all doing too much. Like, why do people love celebrities that much to where it's like, oh my gosh, like the world is ending? And that's why I left at the end, because the other guy was like, what are you doing? Calm down. You don't even know these people. What's your thoughts?
No, you know, we're in the social media world now, right? When you do a challenge or anything like that, to get people's first reaction, I think is what they were going after. And you know, I heard a couple of them say, no, not for, you know, I'm just kidding, right? Like, right, before the person, but you're right. But I think anytime you hear somebody passed away, whether it's a celebrity or not, I think you have an immediate reaction, like, mm-hmm, oh, what happened? You know what I mean?
And I get it. They're
even
human.
If they're not a celebrity,
right? And I get it. They're
that's
human.
Just a natural.
You want to, not even that you want to. If you are a human who has emotions, who you care about people, when somebody passes away, even if I don't know them, I feel sorry and I feel sorrow and I feel sad.
Yeah.
But I'm not like, oh my God, my life is over.
No. But you do have that reaction, celebrity or not celebrity,
right?
You never want to hear anybody passing or anybody dying. And I, like I said, I've had the, you know, very unfortunate the last year or two of like 9 people passing away, going to funerals. And even if it, when somebody tells you that somebody passed away or they, you know, they're in the hospital, they may pass away, your immediate reaction is concern. What can I do to help? Do you guys need anything? When's the funeral? Let me know. I want to make sure I'm there to support.
That's what family, right?
Yeah.
You're not talking about celebrities.
Not celebrity. Right. I'm just saying in general, when people do make that kind of reaction, I think they could have said it was Joe from down the street. And they would have been like,
right,
I see Joe all the time. And, you know, just that natural reaction is to be like,
I see, I see.
The celebrity part would made it funny.
Right. But my thing is, you think they were doing too much in the reactions?
Yeah, but again,
why do you
it's
that?
Social media, so I just think if they would have said any name, the person probably is an over-exaggerator a little bit. And
right.
So they, oh my God, like,
right,
such and such, because they seen the camera was on, so.
And you know what? I think one thing that I am forgetting, just to hold myself accountable, because we do have to go, is that they did say this was a prank that they were doing on their parents to their favorite celebrity. So I feel like if it was just somebody random that they didn't pay attention to.
Yeah, but they would have still had a reaction.
Right. But I could see probably like if their favorite celebrity passed away, it could be like, for example, Fallon said she cried over Aaliyah. I did too.
Yeah.
But also Aaliyah helped me get through things. So I can see that. Yeah. I can for sure.
You definitely can feel connected.
And, so I can correct myself.
And I think these people just kind of, you know, they could have said anybody passed away that they knew,
right,
they would have probably had that same kind of, oh my God, what happened?
Right. I just think sometimes people put too much into celebrities they don't even know.
Yeah. Well, they got that, like you said, they sometimes feel like they got that connection. They probably watch such and such on TV all the time, seen every movie that they came out. So now you feel like you connected to them in what, you know, situation.
Listen, that can always be proven wrong. All right. Guys, this is the Jimmy D Show live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM. I'll be at TGI Fridays Gold Coast Casino tonight from 7:30 to 9:30 p.m. PST. TGI Fridays Gold Coast Casino. Meet me there. All right. See you guys tomorrow.
What's up, everybody? You were just tuned into the Jamie D Show live on KSHP AM 1400. And 107.1 FM. If you aren't in the Las Vegas area, you can catch my show live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook at The Jamie D Show. That's THEJAIMEDESHOW. If you want to advertise your business on my show, email us at info@jamied.com. Thank you all so much for your support. See you tomorrow.